Investing in stocks is a good way to build long-term wealth. And one of the hardest things that we will encounter in doing this is cutting back on other spending, right? We live in a world of excess. It's the American dream. Buy as much as you can, have as much as you can, fill all of your voids. We're never told to cut back. We're never told to save. We're never told to do any of those things because it's good for profit, whether it's to impress people or flaunt or acclimate or just be accepted by everyone around us, or to fill some sort of void, or to get people off of our backs, right? People tend to meddle, and they tend to insert themselves into our personal lives. Some of our reactions are to just go along with the status quo. As a result, what ends up happening is we fill voids. What we end up doing is just filling voids, biting off more than we can chew, leading these depressed lives, which in turn is very good for corporate America because they're then able to advertise to us. They're able to say, "Hey man, your commute sucks. Oh, I know you're sitting in traffic. You go to work, you hate your boss, you hate your colleagues, you hate everything about your life. You might as well drive in comfort. You deserve this new BMW because your life sucks." And so we get caught up in this consumption culture, and it ultimately gets us nowhere except riddled with debt and burdened with possessions. And we end up having no quality of life. It gets us nowhere. You know, when you go to buy a pair of shoes and you pick up those shoes and you go, "These shoes are gonna fill a void. They're gonna make me happy for 10 minutes. Someone's gonna see those shoes and be impressed with me and they're gonna think I'm rich." But that high fades. And what ends up happening is you keep filling that void over and over and over with newer things, more expensive things. We want to be accepted. We want people to be envious. When I'm making a purchase, I look at the item and I go, "Do I really need this? You know, this pair of shoes, it's $200. I could buy a couple of shares in a stock, in some company on Wall Street that pays a pretty good dividend, right? That stock will build wealth over a lifetime. The pair of shoes will make me feel good for a few minutes. That purchase that I'll wear 4 months out of the year and then we'll sit in my closet collecting dust. Do I want to be that guy who has nice things but no money? Or would I rather be a guy who says, "You know, I'm gonna take that $300 and I'm gonna put it in a stock over here that's gonna build me wealth over a lifetime." What would you rather? You know, you probably can't have both. But if you have extra money lying around where you're gonna go and dump it on a pair of shoes or a sweater or a car, or a bigger house, that money is better served invested in stocks. And yeah, that means maybe you'll have to live below your means, but if we can shift this narrative that we just have to be constantly buying things to impress people or fit in and rewrite the American dream so the American dream isn't living beyond your means and spending exorbitant amounts of money to fit in and look rich, but the American dream is instead to live below your means. So the question is, would you rather have all this stuff and really nothing to show for it? Or would you rather have a few nice things, live below your means, and have so much money that you can invest in the stock market? Instead of buying new things to make you happy, you can be saving money and investing in stocks and watching your long-term wealth build and grow over the future. That's, in my opinion, much more enjoyable to know that my future will be taken care of, that I'll be financially independent at some point. I won't be beholden to a boss or colleagues. I don't have all this burden, all this responsibility hanging over me. That's the much better long-term solution to happiness. At least that's what I think. So give this video a like and subscribe. Thanks. Have a good day.